Hello friends, my name is Pranav Vaidya and today I am going to explain you about satellite communication. That is how mobile communication takes place in the satellite system. So in this video, we are going to discuss about three basic terminologies. The first one is routing, then localization and then handover. So continuing with some basics of the satellite communication system. As we all know friends, that satellites orbit around the earth. That is, satellites revolve around the earth in a circular or non-circular path. Satellites in circular orbits always keep the same distance from the Earth's surface. Four different types of satellites orbit can be identified. The first one is GEO, that is geostationary Earth orbit. This having the distance of about 36,000 km above the surface of Earth. The second one is MEO, that is medium Earth orbit. These kind of satellites are also known as intermediate circular orbit, and this type of satellites are located at around 6,000 to 20,000 km from the surface of Earth. The third one is LEO, the low Earth orbit. This type of satellites are located at around 500 to 1500 km from the Earth's surface. The fourth one is HEO, highly elliptical orbit. This type of satellites are categorized in the non-circular orbit satellites, and these are elliptical orbits. This diagram is showing that how mobile satellite system works. As we can see that there are two satellites which having a communication between them with inter-satellite link, and there is also a link between mobile user and satellite, which is known as mobile user link, and there is also a link between gateway or base station and satellite, which is gateway link. So coming back to the first topic, that is routing. Routing is the process of moving the data packets from source to destination. It involves selecting the path to transfer the data packet up to destination. In the general terms, routing is the path between source to destination. It is the selection of path that how a packet is being transferred from one user to another. So this can be done in two ways. The first solution is if the satellite system supports inter-satellite link. One user sends data up to the satellite and the satellite forwards it to the one responsible for the receiver. This large satellite now sends the data down to the earth. This means that only one uplink and one downlink were needed, per direction is needed. The ability of routing within the satellite network reduces the number of gateways needed on the earth. This diagram is showing the solution one, that is the satellites having inter-satellite links. As we can see that these three satellites having inter-satellite link between them. So if a user want to send a data from one gateway to another, it will pass the data to the satellite, and through ISL this data will be transferred to the destined satellite, and from the destined satellite the data is been transferred to the gateway and received by the receiver. The second solution for the routing is if a satellite system does not offer ISL, it is also known as bent pipe solution. The user also sends data up to the satellite, but now this satellite forwards the data to gateway on the earth. Routing takes place in fixed networks as usual until another gateway is reached, which is responsible for the satellite above the receiver. Again, data is sent up to the satellite, which forwards it down to the receiver. This solution requires two uplinks and two downlinks. This solution can be understood by this diagram. As we can see that there is no ISL between these satellites. So if a user of the gateway wants to send the data to another gateway user, so it will transfer the data to the satellite, and the satellite will send the data to another gateway, and through a wired network this packet will be transferred to the destined gateway, and from the destined gateway the packet is being transferred to the satellite, and the satellite and the user will receive the data. So coming back to our second topic of this video, localization. Localization involves identifying a user and tracking its geographical location in order to provide a better user experience. Basically, it is the process of finding the location of the mobile user in the satellite footprint. Localization of user in satellite network is similar to that of terrestrial cellular network. One additional problem arises from the fact that now the satellites also moves. The gateway of the satellite network maintains several registers. The first one is HLR, that is Home Location Register. This register stores all static information about a user as well as his or her current location. The last known location of a mobile user is stored in the Visitor Location Register. For example, if a mobile user is moving from one base station to another station, then his last location in this base station will be stored in the Visitor Location Register. Now, SUMR, that is Satellite User Mapping Register, that stores current position of satellite and the mapping of each user to the current satellite through which communication with the user is possible. Let us now learn that how mobile station is registered. The mobile station initially sends a signal which one or more satellite can receive. Satellites receiving such a signal report this event to a gateway. The gateway can now determine the location of the user by the location of the satellites. User data is requested from the users HLR, VLR and SUMR. Now, calling a mobile station. The call is forwarded to a gateway which localizes the mobile station using HLR, VLR. With the help of SUMR, the appropriate satellite for communication can be found and connection can be set up. The last topic that we are going to discuss is handover. Handover is the process of transferring satellite control responsibility from one earth station to another without loss or interruption of services. For example, if a user is moving from one place to another, so there will be a handover process taking place between base stations. There are four kind of handover. The first one is intra-satellite handover. A user might move from one spot beam of a satellite to another spot beam of the same satellite. A user might move from one place to another place in the same satellite footprint. Mobile station is still in the footprint of the satellite but in another cell. Using special antennas, a satellite can create several spot beams within its footprint. Intra-satellite handover. If a user leaves the footprint of the satellite or if the satellite moves away, a handover to the next satellite takes place. That is, if a user moves from one satellite footprint to another satellite footprint, then there will be a handover between satellite systems. This might be a hard handover or a soft handover. The third one is gateway handover. While the mobile user and satellite might still have a good contact, the satellite might move away from the current gateway. The satellite has to connect to another gateway. As the satellite is moving around the earth, it might be disconnected from one gateway and will be connected to another gateway. So this type of handover is known as gateway handover. The last handover is inter-system handover. Handover from the satellite network to a terrestrial cellular network. That is, if a user is moving to a place where there is no cellular network found, then his device will automatically connect it to the satellite network. Satellite systems are used in remote areas if no other network is available. As soon as traditional cellular network are available, user might switch to this type usually because it is cheaper and offers more latency. Mobile station can reach a terrestrial network again by which might be cheaper and has a lower latency. Thank you for watching this video.